Good morning to everyone. I am Gaurav Gupta. Today we are going to solve each and every question of the exercise 4.3 class 10th from the NCERT Mathematics. I already prepared a video for how to calculate or how to determine whether the lines are parallel, intersecting or coincident in the first lecture. I already uploaded in my YouTube channel, so you can check. If you still not watch my first video, so please go to my playlist of class 10th and see that video. It's very important, because in this lecture what we are going to solve, we are going to solve the next lectures. So please make a look what we have to do in this lecture. Question number one. What's the question number one is what? Please read the statement very carefully. From the pair of linear equations, it means we have two pair of linear equations. In the following problem, and find their solution, and we have to find their solution graphically. So what is first? 10 students of class 10th took part in a maths. It means there are 10 students which are taking parts in a mathematics quiz. If the number of girls is 4 more than the number of boys, what it say? Means the number of girls is more than the number of boys, but we don't know how many number of boys. Please read the statement. From the pair of linear equations, it means we have to use to make a pair of linear equation, and we already know what's the general form of a linear equation is what? Ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. This is the general form of a linear equations. Now in this we have two variables, x and y, so we have to introduce two variables. In this two variables what? One is your number of students of boys, and second one is number of students of girls is y. So I am taking let number of boys is x, and number of girls is y. And we know how many total students? 10 students of class 10. It means we have total number of students is equal to 10. It means according to question, what we have? Number of boys students plus number of girls students is equal to what? Which is equal to 10. And we know number of boys is x, so I am writing here x, plus number of girls students is y, so I am writing y, which is equal to 10. So this becomes our first equations. Now we have to make second equation. We know number of girls is more than boys by 4. So what is number of girls? Number of girls is more than boys, and how many number of boys? So number of boys plus 4. So number of girls I have take y, so it means y is equal to number of boys is what? X. So x plus 4, this is our second equation. Now what we have to do? We have to solve, find their solution graphically. It means we have to solve, and you already know how we do solve graphically, we have to make first algebraically table of these two. So please make a note first, then I will rub the whole statement. Please make a note. Now our work step is, we got two equation, x plus y is equal to 10, and second equation is y is equal to x plus 4. Now we have to solve these equation graphically. That's why we have to prepare a table to represent these algebraic equations. So please make a note. First equation is what? X plus y is equal to 10. And we know how we write the table. Simplest method is what? We have to take first x is equal to 0. Now if we put x is equal to 0, then what we will get? X is equal to 0 means we put 0, 0 plus y is equal to 10. We get y is equal to 10. It means values of x is equal to 0, it gives y is equal to 10. Now second step is what? Put y is equal to 0. Now put y is equal to 0. If we put y is equal to 0, now we get x plus 0 is equal to 10. So we get x is equal to 10. So it means the values of x is 10 and the values of y is 0. This is our line first line. Now we have to do the same step for the second line. What is our second line? Y is equal to x plus 4. Y is equal to x plus 4. Now put same step. Put x is equal to 0. If we put x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0 plus 4. It means we get y is equal to 4. So what's our table is? This is x, this is y. If we put x is equal to 0, what we will get? Y is equal to 4. Now step same, put y is equal to 0. Put y is equal to 0. If put y is equal to 0, it becomes 0 is equal to x plus 4. So we have to find x, that's why we have to take 4 on the left hand side. So it becomes negative 4. So what's the value of y is 0 and the values of x is minus 4. This is our line first and this one is our line 2. Now we have to locate all these points. So please locate. First point is 0 and 10. Suppose I am giving name it as A, B. This is C and D. Firstly we have to locate a point A. X values is 0. Where is x is 0? In this place. X is 0, y is 0. Now what's the value of y is 10? 10 means here. So we get our points this. This is our what? A point. Now we have to locate our second point B. The values of x is 10 and the values of y is 0. The values of x is 10 here and the values of y is 0. It means we get this point. So now we have to draw a line because the line 1 and line 2 are basically represented straight line equation. So you have to meet these two points and draw a line. So I am drawing a line. This is our line 1. Now we have to do the same step for the second line. What's the second line is? The values of x is 0 and values of y is 4. the values of x is 0 and values of y 4. It means we get this point. This point is C. So I am giving name is C. Next point is the values of x is minus 4. So minus 4 is here and the values of y is 0. It means we get this point. Now again join these two points. This point is what? D. Now join these two points. This is line 2 and this is line 1. It means the lines are what intersecting. What we note remarks. Lines are what intersecting. And that intersecting lines gives us solution, and the solution is only one because it gives only a one point. This one is a point. This is unique point solution. This gives us a unique point solution. So this one is your consistent, because you know if we get a solution, it means the system is consistent. So system is consistent. This is our remarks. So by graphically we can locate our graph lines and we can easily tell whether the lines are intersecting, parallel or coincident. So these lines are intersecting. Solution is unique. Unique means one solution. Also write one solution, and system is consistent. Please make a note. So in our first question, we already plot the graph. How looks like the graph? This is your graph, and we already know we get one point intersecting points, and that point is what? This is your intersecting points. Now we have to get the solution. How we get the solution? This type of solution is you have to get by using a graph paper. What's the graph paper? It means you have to plot all this equation in the graph paper and find the solution. How we will get the solution? You have to do perpendicular on that x-axis and y-axis. That value gives the solution. It means if we draw perpendicular, here we get the values of x. It means we get x is equal to 3. Now if I draw the perpendicular on y-axis, it gives the values of y is equal to 7. So what's our solution is? So our solution is x, what x is your number of boys, which is 3, and y is what number of girls, which is 7. So this one is your final answer. Please make a note. Now please read our second part of the question number 1. What is it? 5 pencil and 7 pens together cost of rupees 50. It means if we purchase 5 pencil and 7 pens, we have to pay 50 rupees, but we don't know what's the cost price of 1 pen and 1 pencil. That's why we have to take assume. So let cost of one pencil is rupees x. Say cost of one pen is rupees y. This is the cost of one pen and one pencil, and we purchase 5 pencils. So we get 5 and the cost of pencil is x. So we get 5x. And cost of 7 pen is 7 multiply the cost of pen. Cost of pen is y. Now the total cost is what? Total cost is rupees 50. Same we have to do our second. And 5 pens means 7 pencils, and it becomes 7x plus 5 pens. 5 pens, the total cost is rupees 46. This one is according to your question. So this is basically your according to question. Now what we have to do? The same step, we have to plot these lines. Now take one by one first lines. I have to prepare a table. This one is your x, this is y. This is line 1. The basic option is what? First step is you have to put y, x is equal to 0 and calculate the values of y. But please make a look here. If we solve this, equation is what? 5x plus 7y is equal to 50. If we put x is equal to 0, then what will be the values of y? The values of y will come in fraction. Please make a look here. 5 into 0 plus 7y is equal to 50. It means 5 into 0, 0 plus 7y is equal to 50. So y is equal to what? 50 divided by 7. But it is comes in fraction and it is very difficult to locate such a points. So that's why we have to take now another values of x so that the values of y we can easily plot. So that's why I am in this case not put x is equal to 0, because it doesn't give us the suitable values of y. I have to choose some other values. Suppose if I choose a values, please guess, make a guess. What's the values? Yes. If we take x is equal to 3, then it is possible to get suitable values of y. Put x is equal to 3. Now 5 into 3 plus 7y is equal to 50. 5 into 3, 15 plus 7y is equal to 50. So what's the 7y is equal to 50, and we have to take 15 on the right hand side. 15, which is equal to 35. We get 7y is equal to 35. So what will be the values of y? 35 divided by 7, we get 5. So if we put x is equal to 3, we get y is equal to 5. Now we have to get the second point. Now what we have to do? Now in this case we have to put y is equal to 0 and check whether the values of x is we can plot or not. Put y is equal to 0. Now solve this. 5x plus 7 into 0, which is equal to 50. Now 5x, this is 0, which is equal to 50. Then what will be the values of x is? 50 divided by 5, 10. It means we can locate them. So what are the points? Values of x is what? 10. And the values of y is 5. So this is our first table. Please make a note. Now what's our second equation is what? 7x plus 5 by 7x plus 5y is equal to 46. We have to do the same step. We have to draw a table. this is the values of x and this is the values of y. We have to take the same assumption. First, put x is equal to 0. Now again check. If we put x is equal to 0, either we get the values of y is suitable or not. Let's make a look. If we put x is equal to 0, then this term becomes 0. And we have to take this 5 on the right hand side. 46 is not divided by 5. It means we do not get the values that we can locate. So that's why we have to choose another value. Now I am going to take another x is equal to 3. Please make a note here. If we put x is equal to 3. Now solve this. 7 into 3 plus 5 into y is equal to 46. This is 21 plus 5y is equal to 46. Then 5y is what? 46. And we have to take this 21 on the right hand side. 46 minus 21. We get 25. 5y is equal to 25. Then what will be the values of y? 25 divided by 5, which is equal to 5. It means if we put x is equal to 3, we get y is equal to 5. And this point we can easily be plot. Now our second step is what? We have to find out the second point. The step is same. We have to put now y is equal to 0. And check. If we put y is equal to 0. Sorry, what we did here? In this we put x equal to 3. Now we have to put y is equal to 0. If y is equal to 0, then it means we have to take 7 on the right hand side. And again 46 is not divisible by 7. It means we have to choose another value. So please think, what's the second value is what? Now what's the values? In this we have to carefully choose. If we choose y is equal to minus 2, we put y is equal to negative 2. Now please solve this. 7 into x plus 5 into y. What's the value of y? Is minus 2 is equal to 46. Then 7x minus 10 is equal to 46. 7x and this is 46 and minus 10, it becomes positive 10. Here we get 56. Now what's the value of x is what? X is 56 divided by 7, we get 8. So it's very simple. So what's the point? I'm going to take y is negative 2 and the what the values of x is 8. Now these points can be easily locate in the graph paper. So please make a note, then I will make a graph of such question. Now we have to plot these two lines. So that's why I am giving a name of the points. This is your point A, this is B, this one is C and this one is D. Now first point is A, what? The values of x is 3. 1, 2, 3 here. And the value of y is 5. 5 is what? Here. So we get this point. So I am rubbing this portion. This is our what? A point. Now B point is what? The values of x is 10. The values of x is 10. And values of y is again 5. It means the values of y is again 5. Please make a note first. Please make a note here. In this what we will get? We get y is equal to 0. You can check your notes. Values is x is equal to 10 and values of y is 0. It means we get the point here. This is your P point. Please do correct. Now what we have to do? Now join these two lines. Please join these two lines. This is our line first. Now we have to locate second points of the second line. C point is the values of x is 3, 3 is here, and values of y is 5, it means we get 5. This point is same, so we another get here point C, and the values of x is 8 and values of y is negative 2. What's the point? The values of x is 8 and the values of y is negative 2. Negative 2 means here. So we get a point here. This is point what? This is your point D. Now join these two points. This is our line 2. Now what are the remarks? Again, what lines are intersecting? So I am writing here intersecting, and intersecting gives a one point, so we are get one solution, and which is called also unique solution. One solution is also called unique solution. And what's the solution values? In this we have to do the same step. We have to take perpendicular on the x-axis. So what's the perpendicular? If we draw, we get here 3. So this is what? X is equal to 3. And same we have to do perpendicular on y-axis. This is what? 5. What is x? X is cos of 1 pencil. So it means cos of 1 pencil is 3 rupees. And cos of 1 pen is what? 5. This is our answer, and the system is consistent. So these three points are the remarks points, and the final answer is what? The cost of one pencil is 3 rupees and the cost of one pen is 5 rupees. That is your final answer. Please make a note. If you really like my videos and do require more videos, so please do subscribe my channel Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes. Make share it with your friends also. So thank you once again for watching my video from start to end. We will meet very soon.